spirit of Detroit.
I don't know what's been going on. Maybe I'm delusional, but recently I have been thinking, low-key, the Pistons can be the biggest surprise in the NBA next season and maybe squeak into the playoffs through the play-in tournament.
Can you explain maybe what you think this team is capable of, or what the possibilities are even this season?
I think the sky's the limit. You know, I think we just want to take one day at a time. And obviously just win and get better and be the best team we could be by the end of the season and try to win as many games as possible, but still, you know, develop that culture and character as a team for the future. I don't think we set any limits for ourselves or any certain goals besides winning every game and getting better every day. So I think that's our mentality and focus.
YouTube! Welcome to Spirit of Detroit Podcast. Like, comment, subscribe for more thought-provoking content like this. Click the bell icon button. My biggest thing with the Detroit Pistons is the fact that people don't believe in them in a city. I feel like most individuals in Detroit try to taper their expectations because in Detroit, we've had a drought. And I mean, we went to the playoffs like 2 years ago. Who cares about Blake Griffin's playoff team? We knew they was going to get swept. They was entirely too old. They was not. Come on now. But we've had a drought. We've had Frank as a coach, Kuster, the Kuster insurrection. Remember that shit? We had we've had Curry. We've had some terrible coaching, playing, all that shit. Anything you can think of. Had, just disarray, dysfunctional. We didn't even know what's going on. You know? And now, we see a fresh, exciting, young rebuild. You have 9 players under 25 years old. And I know that's probably going to be a problem for most. People are going to say, hey, we can't win this young. I think we can. Atlanta proved that. That's why I'm saying that the Detroit Pistons are most likely going to be a 41-win team. 39 for sure. And I can bet my check on that. And I'm not trying to cap. I know that we taper our expectations because the Lions are in town, and we taper our expectations because no one expects us to win and the media is against us and all that blah, blah, blah. But me personally, I don't taper nothing. I look at a small forward like Sadiq Bey, who could play power forward. I look at that guy and I'm like, wow, he almost broke a record for threes last year. Killian Hayes showed flashes of greatness. 20-point game. One of the last games of the season after he came back from a hip injury. 20-point game. Come on now. Jeremy Grant, all-star player. Cade Cunningham, rookie of the year. Not rookie of the year, but he will be rookie of the year. I believe it. And if he's not, that's just the media fucking with us because we're Detroit. But he earned the expectations because he's the first overall draft pick. He's amazing. Kay Cunningham, he's probably going to be my thumbnail because he's amazing. This whole team from top to bottom, like Dwayne Casey said in an interview that he doesn't see anything beyond a 10-man rotation at this point because he wants, to manage minutes effectively. And get the right lineups in there and get guys to gel. He doesn't expect more than a 10-man rotation, but right now, as of now, this team has 17 people or 18 because they just signed Jared Cunningham. Shout out to Jared. They just signed Jared Cunningham to a training camp deal. They have 18 people in training camp now that I can see any of them guys starting, any of them guys playing. I could go through the Jacksons, Hamadou Diallo, like, we just Saban Lee, we just name, and it's amazing. I grew up in a Pistons era where we had five guys and that was it, and maybe Lindsey Hunter, maybe Tony Delt. We could go seven deep. We can go 10 deep with this lineup. And I think I've always been high on that. I've always said that to either Joe Polo, the media, whatever, YouTube. I've always said that. But now I think fans really need to gather in and really try to enjoy this. Because right now, it's the Lions are going to have a rough season. And I'm very committed to making Detroit Pistons content. Okay? I'm going to squeeze in two or three games, whatever. Especially that first game on October 6th. That first preseason game. They play the Spurs. And man, I'm just excited. I don't know. Like, I'm committed to making Detroit Pistons content because that's going to be a respite for the Detroit Lions. That's going to be like, you know, like, oh, excitement's in the air. You know, the hockey team, like, I'll cover all that shit. Because, honestly, the Detroit Pistons are just a new-look basketball team. They are in the second phase of a rebuild. So now, realistically, it's just about building, gelling together, coming together, and winning in the culture. And there's no personalities that are, like, chaotic on this team. They're really a strong team. They really, you know, be together. They really try to work out together. Five players stayed in Detroit during the offseason. And that's including Killian Hayes, who was much maligned by everybody except myself. I see no flaws here. I just got to get these guys in an 82-game season. That's it. That's all they need is 82 games. And if they have 3 years, 2 years from now, they're going to be probably a first seed in the NBA playoffs, if not a second seed. Because this team is just so full of talent. And I know we had a 10-man rotation, and he doesn't want to go under 12, but you have 18 guys that can start any given day. Jamarco Pickett on the wing or at power forward is going to be something. He has a two-way contract this year. I'm going to be excited to see him, Hamadou Diallo, Kay Cunningham, Killian Hayes, Sadiq Bey, Jeremy Grant, Kelly Olynyk. It's exciting. They are lit. Now, granted, we all know that, you know, we're going to get, you know, some all-stars, you know, we already know. But I guarantee you, they're going to take it to the Lakers. They're going to take it to... We're going to get whooped in some games. But I guarantee you, we're going to take it to, like, top tier teams. Like the Lakers, the old-ass Lakers. We'll win one out of three of them games. We'll handle our business. So I'm expecting a lot of big things from Detroit. Playoffs is totally possible. I just wanted to put my prediction video out here. And, you know, like, comment, subscribe for more thought-provoking content like this. If you're first time here, check out more of my videos. The Lions video I just did went crazy. Shout out to all the YouTubers that supported me. Shout out to Detroit Drew and Gridiron Blitz, Micro Mike. I think most of the YouTubers fuck with me. Shout out to Motor City. Shout out to, you know, Amon Analytic. Shout out to the whole, you know, the whole gang. Shout out to Luke G. I got a lot of allies in this shit, man. And I just really appreciate all the content y'all spewing out and all the content y'all keep messing with. Because now I got to get another hobby. You know, I'm committed to the Lions, but I got to be committed to getting some hockey in here and some motherfucking some basketball. Because y'all, we competing, baby. This is great. This is exciting. So, yeah, like, comment, subscribe. I love y'all.